And with Anzac Day looming, preparations are being finalised for Perth's famous dawn service. Reporter Nick Way takes us behind the scenes tonight for a quick word with the War Memorial's Chief Warden.
A sacred place like the State War Memorial has special people charged with its care. And Ruth Sheen leads that group as we head towards Anzac Day 2012. And Ruth, how did you come to be the Chief Warden of the memorial?
My father, Max Sheen, was one of the world's war heroes. He was Australia's most highly decorated submariner and fought in campaigns in the North Atlantic, Ocean and the Pacific. He was a warden of the War Memorial himself 10 years ago, and since his death I've been given the great honour of following in his footsteps.
That's amazing. Now, what are the duties of a warden?
Well, they are a great honour. They are to conduct the services which are held here throughout the year.
So what do you see as the benefits to today's modern community of this place and of Anzac Day?
The message of Anzac Day, the spirit of Anzac Day, is service and mateship. And I think that that is a useful message for the community, regardless of whether they've been in wars themselves, regardless of their position. That's a message which we would all benefit from being part of.
Do you have any special links with people whose names are engraved beneath the cenotaph?
Yes, surprisingly. One that we found out only about just recently. We found a medal in the family and the name Irving Seal was engraved on it. And Dad and I had no idea who Irving Seal was. We knew we had some relations called Seal. We did some research through the Australian War Memorial and found out that Edward Irving Seal had been in the Great War and had died in 1918. And when I was given the key to the War Memorial, one of the first things I did was had a look at the names down there, and sure enough, under the 51 Battalion is Edward Irving Seal's name. And that was quite a special thing for me to do, to see my relative's name engraved.
That's wonderful. Ruth, how do you feel as you stand here in the pre-dawn on Anzac Day?
Anzac Day, and particularly the dawn service, is a very humble affair. It's a silent affair. People don't expect razzmatazz or glory. They come to pay their respects to those who have contributed to the position that they're now in. I'm always very aware of the hardship that people faced in defence of this country. I'm aware of the hardships that their families faced in losing loved family members. I feel very humble. I feel very privileged. And as a state, we are very lucky to have had the ancestors do what they have done for us.
Ruth Sheen, thanks for having a quick word.
Thank you, Nick.